Hello, myself Dr. Vithul M. Patel, and in today's lecture we will discuss about the different operations carried out in the lathe machine. So you can see the figure. During this operation, how can we perform this type of operations with the use of the different cutting tools, single blade cutting tool. So we can say that before continuing any operation in the lathe machine, we have to load the job and center it on headstock cylinder. So in the lathe operation, the headstock cylinder holds the job, it rotates with the same speed as a spindle. The carriage holding the tool on the tool post also carries gives the tool post moves longitudinally or crosswise direction to give the desired feed on the job. So in these two motions, we can say longitudinally and crosswise, has to remove the chips of the metal and giving the proper shape of the jaw. So in the lathe machine, versatile machine, that it can produce the another lathe, we can say that. It is tough to mention which operations are not performed in the lathe machine. Many of the operations which are using for the different manufacturing process, that we can easily perform in the lathe machines. So some of the important lathe operations that we will discuss in the detail. First of all, centering. So what is centering? Why we use it? We use this operation for producing a conical hole in the face of the job to make the bearing support of the lathe center when the job is to be hauled between two centers. Which centers? Headstock and tailstock. It is centering. Then facing operation in the lathe machine. Facing operation is for making the ends of the job to produce a smooth flat surface with the axis of operation of certain length of job. It is facing. Then we can say turning. It is one of the most important operation compared to the others. In simple language also we can say that if you want to remove some metal or material from the workpiece which is round bar, or we can say that on the round bar, the operation by which we remove the excess material from the work is to produce a concept or a cylindrical surface. So there are many types of turning operations, straight turning operations, shoulder turning, rough turning, finish turning, taper turning, eccentric turning. So what is straight turning? First of all, we want to discuss. This operation is done to produce a cylindrical surface by removing some excess material from the workpiece, right? So it is done by some ways. First of all, we have to mount the jaw in chalk and between centers of the tailstock and headstock, then hold the cutting tool, the tool post at the cutting edge, the jaw axis slightly above it, then set the spindle as per the desired feed whenever we required, give depth of cut as per the finish or rough cut you want, start the machining. Engage automatic feed to move the carriage with the tool to the desired length as disengage the feed and carriage is brought back to the starting, etc. Right? Then we will discuss about the taper turning operation. Yes, first let me give you an idea about the taper. The taper is defined as a uniform decrease or increase in the diameter of the workpiece along with its length, right? That is taper. What is taper turning? The operation by which a conical surface of the gradual reduction in the diameter of the cylindrical workpiece or round bar is produced. It is called taper turning. So there are many different methods for taper turning operations. First one is the taper turning by foam tool. Also we can perform it with the use of foam tool by fueling the compound rest, tailstock set power method, by taper turning attachment also. So these are the different methods to perform the taper turning operations, right? Next one, that is by chamfer tool, which is also you can see in the figure. Chamfer tool, it is also you can see in the slide. What is chamfering? Chamfering is used for beveling the end of the jaw to remove the burrs. to look better to make a passage of the nut into the bolt. So it is the importance of the chamfering operations. This operation is done after thread cutting, knurling, rough turning, all these all these operations. If you have already performed on the round barrel or workpiece, then after this all operation performed, then we can easily perform it very well with the use of the lathe machines. Next one is a knurling operation. So you know that it is different operation, we can say that, from others, because it is the process of the producing a rough surface on the workpiece to provide the effective gripping. And other operations that we are performing with the lathe machine, that is any method, any operations, we are removing some metal or material from the workpiece in different size and shapes. But this type of operation is also called is a knurling operation, because with the use of this operation we are producing some rough surfaces on the workpiece providing some effective gripping, right? So knurling tool, which is held rigidly on the tool post and pressed against the rotating jaw, so that leaving the exact face smiling of the tool on the surface of the jaw, right? Important operation another, that is thread cutting. That is the operation that is used to produce the helical groove on a cylindrical or conical surface by feeding the tool longitudinally when the jaw revolves between the two centers, right? That is threading, outer threading, inner threading. We can give the example for the threading operation, that is nut and bolt, right? So nut, it is the example of inner threading, and bolt is the example of outer threading, right? Now drilling. So it is not necessary to make a hole. We have to use drilling operation. Also, if we have lathe, then we can also perform the drilling operation with the use of the lathe machine. So drilling is an operation by which we can make a hole in the jaw. In the operation, the jaw is rotated at the turning speed on the lathe axis, and the drilling tool is fitted at the tailstock spindle, right? And the tailstock is moved towards the jaw by hand pin. So in this operation, we can enlarge the diameter of the existing hole in the jaw by turning inside with some firm tool, which is known as a boring tool, right? So it is also important if you want to make bore on the workpiece, or we can say if we want to perform the boring operation on the lathe machine, then also we can use the lathe machine. Reaming operation. So reaming is the operation for sizing or finishing a drill hole to the required size by a tool called reamer. It is reaming. Then another is tapping operation. We use this operation for creating internal threads within a hole by means of a tool called tap. Tap is also one of the important tool which is used to operate or create an internal thread within a hole. Right, parting off, it is the operation of the cutting off a bar type jaw after complete machining process. If you want to give some desired shape and size to the workpiece, and already we have performed some different operations to give the desired shape and size of the workpiece. After completion of this all the operations, we have to perform this operation, which is called parting off. It is the operation of the cutting off a bar type job after complete the machining process. So in this operation, a bar type job is held in a chuck, rotates at turning speed, a parting off tool is fed into the job slowly until the tool reaches the center of the job. So these are the different operations carried out on the lathe machines. Thank you.